Hi there, I'm Tom from Danfoss Climate Solutions. How do you save costs on system shutdown time and service if you have a solenoid valve failure in your system? Well, to answer that, have a look at this video.
The videos troubleshoot the following Danfoss solenoid valve types: the EVR valve family, the EVU valve family, the CSV valve family, and the coils used for these valves. This video gives you troubleshooting tips related to how to identify possible solenoid valve failures in a refrigeration system depending on valve location and valve function. Now, how do we efficiently identify possible solenoid valve failures in a refrigeration system? In other words, how might the failures affect the refrigeration system? Here you see the potential solenoid valve failures which might happen in the refrigeration system. This being valve noise and vibration, valve does not open or opens only partially, valve does not close or closes only partially, valve internal or external leakage, and valve coil failures. These valve failures might affect the refrigeration system in different ways, depending on the valve location and the function in the system. The typical solenoid valve locations and functions are shown in this principal diagram of a refrigeration system. Valve noise and vibration are identified in the same way no matter where the valve is located in the system. Here you can see an example of such failures. As seen, you will normally hear and or feel by hand such valve failures. If we then look at the liquid line as illustrated here, here you normally use solenoid valves for liquid injection, liquid shutoff, and evaporator pump down. Now, here you see an overview of how possible solenoid valve failures might affect the refrigeration system when the valve is located in the liquid line. This being, the evaporator does not give sufficient cooling and or compressor does not start or stops too often. This caused by a lack of refrigerant due to the valve not opening or only being partially open, or the valve coil is not working correctly. And the evaporator gives too much cooling and or compressor cannot do pump down. This caused by too much refrigerant due to the valve not closing or only being partially closed, the valve is internally leaking, or the valve coil is not working correctly. Check out other online solenoid valve troubleshooting videos to get more details about these valve failures and how to solve them so that you can efficiently reduce system shutdown and service costs. If we then look at the hot gas line as illustrated here, here you normally use solenoid valves for hot gas bypass, hot gas defrost, and unloader control. Now, here you see an overview of how possible solenoid valve failures might affect the refrigeration system when the valve is located in the hot gas line. This being, the evaporator freezes and or compressor starts and stops too often. This caused by a lack of hot gas due to the valve not opening or only being partially open, or the valve coil is not working correctly. The evaporator gets too warm and or compressor overheats. This caused by too much hot gas due to the valve not closing or only being partially closed, the valve is internally leaking, or the valve coil is not working correctly. Check out the other online solenoid valve troubleshooting videos to get more details about these valve failures and how to solve them so that you can efficiently reduce system shutdown and service costs. If we then look at the suction line, as illustrated here, here you normally use solenoid valves for capacity control and restriction. Now, here you see an overview of how possible solenoid valve failures might affect the refrigeration system when the valve is located in the suction line. This being, the evaporator does not give sufficient cooling. This caused by too low suction pressure due to the valve not opening or only being partially open, or the valve coil is not working correctly, and insufficient evaporator defrost and or compressor overheats. this caused by too high suction temperature due to the valve not closing, only being partially closed, the valve is internally leaking, or the valve coil is not working correctly. Check out the other online solenoid valve troubleshooting videos to get more details about these valve failures and how to solve them so that you can efficiently reduce system shutdown and service costs. So to summarize, from this solenoid valve troubleshooting video, you now know how to identify possible valve failures in a refrigeration system. This way, ensuring that you can efficiently identify root causes, make corrective actions, and minimize system shutdown time and service costs. Please search for the other online solenoid valve troubleshooting videos to learn about relevant valve failure root causes and how to solve them with suitable corrective actions.
Have a look at the other Danfoss online videos about solenoid valve troubleshooting and other videos where I talk about valves. Thanks for watching!